Are you struggling to find academic journal articles? Well, struggle no more, because today I'm going to show you how to use A State Library's OneSearch to very quickly and easily find relevant scholarly journal articles on the topic of your choice. The first order of business is to navigate to the A State Library homepage. You can get there from any A State webpage by simply clicking Library at the top. Once you've done that, you're going to look for the OneSearch bar that is situated in the middle of the library's webpage. Today, let's say we're interested in domestic violence. Now, before I click search, I want to make this a phrasal search because I want to find articles about domestic violence. That exact phrase, those two words in that order. Why? There's always the off chance that I find irrelevant results. For instance, in this case, maybe the word domestic, cat shows up, and violent. So I've got nothing but articles about cat fights, which is not what I'm interested in. Instead, perhaps I'm interested in, well, domestic violence, as in intimate partner abuse, spousal abuse, things of that nature. So, back to our search box. Before we click search, though, remember, we're looking for scholarly journal articles. We don't want books, we don't want magazines, we don't want newspapers, we don't want videos, all that jazz. Well, there's a very simple solution to that. We click the box that says peer-reviewed. Scholarly journal, academic journal, peer-reviewed journal, basically the same thing. So let's click peer-reviewed and then see what happens. Here's what a results page for OneSearch will look like. And I want to pause to briefly mention that this is really an ineffective search, mainly because it's much too broad. Domestic violence is a very big topic. So in a realistic search scenario, we would have a research question that is much more refined. And because of that, our results would be much smaller. You can see here, or we would have many fewer results. You can see here we have 97,463. This is entirely too many results. So let's just real quick make this much more specific, a narrower number of results, a manageable number of results. How do we do that? Well, we use the advanced search. And let's do a couple of fancy things. We'll say domestic violence or intimate partner violence, or I don't know, spousal abuse or family violence. Those are close enough in meaning that I'm satisfied with results that have any of those terms that appear. However, that may differ for your research purposes, but this is just strictly explanatory. Of course, using OR is simply going to expand our results. Remember, we had almost 100,000 results just from domestic violence alone, so adding these additional terms using OR will only increase that number. So we actually need to use AND to reduce the number. So let's add stalking. And let's also add social media. So you can envision your research question as something like, how has domestic violence been perpetuated via stalking by social media means? That wasn't a very elegant way of putting it, but maybe that's our research question and we want to see what we can find. From here, we'll just click search again. Now we've arrived at a very manageable 426 results. Ideally, this is where you want to be. If you have thousands and thousands of results, you're simply too broad in your approach. So in the hundreds, it's much more manageable, and you've probably settled upon a decent research question and then translated it into good search terms. Let's take a look at a few technical aspects of OneSearch now. First off, everything that we find here should be part of our library's collection. That is, you shouldn't have to use interlibrary loan, which is a service to request materials from other libraries. However, sometimes you want to make sure you get everything that exists, in which case there's a small checkbox towards the top here that says add results beyond your library's collection. And that way you'll do a larger, more thorough search of the literature. But let's just leave it with what we have right now. Let's look at a specific result. So I'm going to scroll a little bit here to this article. Online Blaming and Intimate Partner Violence, a Content Analysis of Social Media Comments. So I can get the abstract and some additional metadata about the article by clicking on preview. And then to actually access the article, you'll note that there is a link that says full text online. Click that link and it takes you to the article itself. Let's go back. Some other features within OneSearch here are a permanent link to this article or the abstract of the article, the ability to cite the article. You have several choices. All of the most common and widely used styles, Chicago, MLA, APA, etc. Remember, even though this widget is available, it is an automated process and you would want to compare it to your actual, in this case, APA handbook or manual. You can email this to yourself to review later. You can save this to a folder. However, if you do that, you want to make sure that you create an account first so that anything you save, you can get back to later. If you simply start saving items without creating an account, then the next time you open the browser, it's all disappeared. And then there's a few more citation possibilities. The last thing that I want to mention are the limits or filters that you can set on your results. These will also reduce the number of results that you get. On the left side of the screen, you have any number of limits here, or they call them filters. For our part, we've already limited to peer-reviewed journal articles, although sometimes you want to, for instance, limit to a certain date range. You don't want older articles or newer articles, whatever the case may be. So let's say we just want articles from the last 5 years. That got rid of exactly 100 results. So now we're down to 326, an even more manageable number. There are subject terms that you can limit to. I tend to avoid these. I don't always trust that these are perfectly executed. You can limit by author, database. OneSearch is a discovery service, which means that it aggregates a number of databases into one interface. I don't really find a lot of utility in picking a particular database, so I mostly ignore this. Author, that may be of use to you, who knows? Similar to the database or the subject terms, I don't always trust that these are perfectly executed. So for the most part, I focus on my search terms and trust that by developing an effective search with relevant search terms, I won't have to rely upon these subject area, subject term filters for my purposes. Lastly, you can limit by language. You can also receive contextual chat help, immediate, 24/7. While you're searching OneSearch by simply asking your question in the chat box as you're searching. So maybe for whatever reason it says you can access something, you follow the link, you're unable to access it, well, chat might be the answer for you. All right, so that is a relatively quick overview of OneSearch and how to use it to find academic journal articles. We have several other videos that cover different topics about searching and library resources that you can review on our library's YouTube channel. So please don't hesitate to do that. And I hope you got something out of this video.